No pressure. Because like the whole year has been coronavirus. I haven't had to introduce myself as an artist or producer in like a good few months. I need to remember what I'm about, who I am. Hey, I'm Melle Brown. I'm a music producer, DJ and radio host.
Hey, my name's Hamzaa and I am a singer and I'm also a songwriter from London.
My name is Callie Claire, I'm 21. I'm a singer, songwriter, producer, and I'm from London.
I'm working with Hamzaa and Callie Claire, two artists that I'm really excited about, and I just love their tone. I'm really hoping to achieve like a soulful jazz influenced track, house infused basically. I love soulful house, so if I can do it with two amazing voices such as Hamzaa and Callie Claire, I'm all over it.
I just thought it would be really nice for us to all come together and bring like what we all do into one room, and there's nothing better than working with other women and having women behind the camera, having women behind the you know, in the scenes, in the engineering, doing all of that stuff. I think that for me is exciting, and it's for Abbey Road to create this program for us to actually have the opportunity to start that conversation and to start that norm, even if it is for today, and you know, people will see this and then think, okay, actually I can do that.
Well, this is my first time at Abbey Road, so I'm so excited. I know like the history of the building and all that sort of stuff and who's been here, so really exciting. And just to be part of something that's just like femininity and woo, just like girl power. I love it.
In the music production world, I think we really need more women, and I think it's really important to have women doing production, so like younger women can aspire to be and see, you know, that you can achieve and do well in this side of the industry. It means a world to be one of the first producers on this Equalise course, because I mean there's a lot of big footsteps to fill basically.
I'm really glad that the people involved today, they felt like they were comfortable in the studio. It never happened to me in my career to have a team of just female in the room. Artist, producer, musician, songwriter. I mean, it felt awesome to me, and it's for sure something that I would love to do again.
I definitely feel like I'm one of few as a female producer, and just generally, like just being in the room in sessions, you're usually with guys, not usually girls. Girls are usually like writers.
I think it's not been the easiest journey, but I think now attitudes are starting to change towards women in music production. Sometimes it can work to your advantage if people are kind of shocked about what you can do or, you know, how your music sounds and stuff. But I mean, it's never really been easy, like breaking the door down, shall we say.
If we're just putting like real, straight and simple, I'm a big black girl coming into the industry, and we haven't really had that specific kind of description of an artist in a long time. I think the closest you could probably get to what I am is like someone like Laura Mvula, who's got short hair, she's black, she's not a typical like R&B singer. And so for me, I think the struggle was making sure I found the right team to kind of execute my vision and not box me in to like one thing. I think it's imperative to surround yourself by the right people and the right team, because at the end of the day, you know, things do change and you lose some people along the way, you gain some people along the way, but if you start with that really strong foundation, I say that because that's just the reality of the music industry, things are forever changing, but as long as you've got your like solid, firm foundation of people, the rest is kind of, you know, you'll meet people from a different marketing team or at the label, a new staff member might come on and be, you know, whatever, or even if you're independent, you might find that someone new comes in and starts helping, or you work with a different company to do your distribution or whatever it might be. But as long as you have your strong foundation, people who believe in you as a person as well, not just the artist, I think that's really important.
It's not easy in this day and age because everyone has to sustain their actual life. Mm-hmm. And studio sessions, you know, hiring a studio is not cheap. Like using your spare time to work on your craft and you know, where you can develop your skills, I think will always make you a better producer. But it's also finding that time to do so and not beating yourself up if you haven't been able to, because life does get in the way.
Being a craftsman is having the discipline to still continue to work even when you're not inspired. So when the inspiration is not there, you're still honing your craft because you're constantly putting into place that discipline. So you will always be at a certain level, and then when the inspiration does come, you are able to level up and excel.
If you sing a certain way, just sing that way when you record. Because I think sometimes when I first started recording, I used to try and put on this voice.
Like the recording voice.
Yeah, so I sound like, in the mountains. Like, I just tried to sound cooler. And it just doesn't work. Like, it just doesn't bang. Like, I come from a very much like a theatre background, so my voice is a lot more in the depths of my diaphragm. Don't try and sing for the microphone, just sing. Remember, it's amplifying your voice. It's not to make you sound like Beyonce, it's not to make you sound like anyone else. It's actually gonna pick up what you sound like. So if you go on stage and you know you're not gonna sing like that, don't sing like that in the booth.
As a young singer, I feel like the most important thing to do is to learn to engineer yourself. You don't have to do it to like the greatest standard, but I feel like it sets you up so much because then you know what you want to do when you get in a room with someone. I feel like as a singer, it's kind of your responsibility just to know what to do with your vocals.
Yeah.
Not to like the point where like it needs to sound like it's kinda mixed and mastered, but just to a point where like you're happy with it.
But it's literally
record yourself.
How to record yourself, how to stop a take, how to cut a take, how to comp a vocal.
So comping is basically choosing the parts of a take that you want to include in your final edit. So you would normally do more takes of the same thing, let's say in this case main vocals. It's really important because sometimes you capture, even if you don't want it, in different takes, some colors of the vocals, some bits that the singer is not even thinking about.
My tips would be just practice, practice, practice. Like, you can never not learn enough on YouTube. YouTube is like such a resourceful tool. Like, there's like Pensado's Place and like loads of different great YouTube videos that you can just learn how to produce, how to mix. I would kind of keep my eye on the scene in terms of like up and coming underground artists that are coming through, because an artist is always going to need a producer. The more you collaborate with people or just get in the room with people, the more you're able to just be in the right place at the right time and just like learn off of like other producers and stuff, and just get in sessions with as many people as you can. Like, get in sessions with people, like session musicians, like Sin, and just come up with different melodies and stuff. I mean, that's another thing, like, if you don't play like piano or stuff to the best of your ability, working with a session musician will always like help elevate the track per se. So you can never, yeah, it's never, it works as a disadvantage working with other people. Watching what I do for me if
you're scared to make a move. You have to know who you are. Like, you have to not be afraid to get it wrong. And that's like easier said than done, obviously. But just if you're going into a room, you want to present yourself the best, like the best version possible that you can present. So try not to be afraid, even though it's hard to do. But just stick with your friends, because once like you and your friends like get some sort of chemistry together, it doesn't matter who the person is. Once you have a chemistry together, you know like what works for you, like you feel comfortable, then you can get your best ideas out, and it doesn't really...
And then you can bring other people into the room. So if you, so if you've got people in the industry that are your brothers and they work and they produce and they do this, get together, get a space, even if it's in the bedroom, every day, every night, whatever it is, like just bang out ideas.
Even if your friends are not in the industry, get together still.
Yeah, no, that's true.
Everyone starts not in the industry, so
yeah, that's true.
You just kind of end up there.
Yeah, so if you've got friends that can play, that's all.
We was friends before we was both like doing sessions.
Yeah, that's true. We knew each other from when we were 13, and now I sit in the Abbey Road Studios.
I think just be persistent, be open to learn different genres, be open to networking, be open to listening to loads of different styles of music, because that definitely influences how you play and how you hear things as well. Because, for example, Western pop music is so different to Indian raga, and the sounds and the tones you get from both of them separately and collaborated is magical. That's why fusion music is amazing, because the fusion of two different genres or cultures and stuff like that just creates something different, and you're always able to go and explore different avenues.
Anything that you see anyone else doing, you can definitely do it. All you need is time and a little bit of patience, like learning new software, but yeah, just that you can do it. And like, don't be too hard on yourself, because everyone has to start somewhere, and you're not gonna like get like a perfect bounce from the drums when you do it first, or you're not gonna get like a perfect mix or anything like that. I feel like in stage, you have to learn in stages, definitely.
Yeah, and again.
This industry is cutthroat, so you have to come in on smoke. You have to come ready, like you have to come with your brand, like your who you are as a person, your image
solidified, so they can't change it as well.
Solidify yourself. If you want to wear leotards, wear
it.
Leotards.
Yeah.
If you want to wear baggy trousers and hoodies,
do it.
Do it, but do it to the like to the core. Where
don't be embarrassed.
You can hit up like a person that does customizations and have all the hoodies that you wear are only hoodies that you wear, and that could be a thing for you. And if it's the it's about the music, you got to make sure that your music is something that you know that you can continue to make and be happy and perform, and you know, also have room for growth. You don't want to hit your peak before you even start. You don't want to feel like you've hit your peak before you even start. So give yourself room for growth. But one thing I will say is come ready.
Know what's going on around you. Because
one
of the things that I've realised is the music industry or the music business is not just music, it's business as well.
100%.
So you have to know what's going to come at you, like what possibilities there are, who could try and trick you, because not everyone has the best intentions. And you have to be involved in the business, because it is a business.
Learn the business.
Yeah.
Learn it, study it, read it, breathe it, sleep it, because it's going to feed you. At the end of the day, it's going to feed your career.
And if you don't know what's going on, then you'll be taken advantage of.
Yeah. Unless you're...
And lawyers will like, just look walk you, like, over you.
What's that?
Yeah.
What? £50,000? Oh, let me just enter there.
Deep,
then I'll
go deeper, babe.
If you go deep, then I'll go. Oh, so cool. She's so nice. And she can sing.
She's the second and only female engineer that I've met. It's so, like, unusual to see a woman behind a desk, and it's really nice, actually. And I feel like that's maybe one of the reasons why I felt kind of more comfortable today. Just seeing, like...
All women.
Someone like you.
I've never in my life thought that I would be helpful, that actually what I do could help other people to get involved in this amazing thing that is the music industry. Abbey Road Studios decided to put effort and time in something like this instead of choosing something else. It's really meaningful. It makes me feel like I'm a part of something or of a place that cares about me, and not only as an employee, but as like a female in that's working in the music industry. It's amazing what we did today, and I hope that it's gonna inspire someone somewhere. It's kind of not
great. I prefer to make us two. A tip, I would say, take your time. Music will always be here. Whether it's streaming, whether it's playing at the speakers in the airspace and the aerodynamic space shuttle, music will always be here and needed. Don't rush your plan. Don't rush your, you know, execution. Don't compromise. Never compromise. But learn to negotiate, because, you know, like, when I say don't compromise, I mean don't compromise your integrity and you as yourself as a person. When it comes to the art and the creative direction and stuff, sometimes, you know, you work with people that do their job, blah, blah, blah. But you as a person, don't compromise your integrity, your sanity. It's a big, bad world out here. It's big and bad. It will eat you alive. No, joking. No, honestly, if the real is, like, the industry is a hard place to be, like any industry is. But if you want it bad enough, you gotta know that it comes with that. I'm pro at this now. Are you laughing at me? Hey, so
I'm gonna be singing this all night.
Deeper. Well, like, they didn't record that, did they? I hope not.